Let's continue section 1.1 with a little more discussion of the idea of variability, that things are constantly changing in the world around us. Things vary. And there's an important concept in math and also in statistics of the idea of a variable. A variable is a very central topic to statistics. Knowing what a variable is crucial to understanding statistics. Your book has this definition of a variable, which I don't actually like that much. So let's forget that. Here is a better definition. A variable is any characteristic, number, or quantity that can be measured or counted. I like this because it's a little bit more broad. We're not necessarily just measuring something from the population. For example, the number rolled on a die is a variable. For our car example, a variable could be something you measure on a car, like its color or its miles per gallon. These are all variables because they change. Variables are not constant. Why are they called variables? Because they change. They're not the same. Every car doesn't have the same color. Every car doesn't have the same miles per gallon. And when you roll a dice, you don't get the same number every time. These are all measurable things that are changing. And so we call all these things variables. There are a couple of types of variables that we want to distinguish between. They are a qualitative variable, another word for that is categorical, versus a quantitative variable. And let's look at quantitative variables first. The book's definition is they provide numerical measures of individuals, so they're numbers. Importantly, you can perform arithmetic operations on them, like addition and subtraction. What are things that we can measure that if we added or subtracted to them, we would get something that was meaningful? Say height or weight or miles per gallon. These are all quantities that are quantitative variables. And opposing that is the idea of a qualitative variable. These are measurable characteristics, like every variable, but you can't perform numeric operations on them, like color, right? I mean, obviously you can subtract anything from color. That doesn't make any sense. Or gender. That is a characteristic. It is a categorical variable. But interestingly enough, say something like your zip code. Well, that's a number, right? So you think, okay, is that a quantitative variable? Well, no, because you can't perform arithmetic operations on it and have that be meaningful. If you took a room full of people and you got all their zip codes together and you found the average zip code by adding up all their zip codes and dividing by the number of people in the room, that would be meaningless. A zip code is a number, but it's not a quantitative variable because doing arithmetic with a zip code doesn't give you a meaningful conclusion. Let's look at an example here of some different variables and try to determine whether they're qualitative or quantitative. And just as a reminder, another word for qualitative is categorical. Let's look at these variables. So what do we got here? There's a researcher and she's studying something. Here's the source. It's from the International Journal of Behavioral Nutrition. We've got five different variables here and we're trying to determine whether they are qualitative variables or whether they are quantitative variables. I would recommend pausing the video right now and you've got five things here and classify them as qualitative or quantitative. Write that down. Writing down things is good for your brain. It helps you remember things. So pause the video and do these A, B, C, D, E, either qualitative or quantitative. Okay, did you pause it? I hope you did. So let's go through. So nationality, that is a qualitative variable. Number of children, oh, that is a quantitative variable. You could have an average number of children, that makes sense. Household income in the previous year, that is a number and that is quantitative. the level of education of somebody, presumably whether they've had a college degree or a high school degree, that is a qualitative variable. And the daily intake of whole grains measured in grams per day, that is quantitative.